It's the talk of the town, monkeypox. Technically, anyone can get it, but some factors make you more susceptible. Stick around to find out more. Hi guys, I'm Lane, your doctor on demand for fun and factual health education. Monkeypox, or MPX, is a virus. It was first seen around 1970 in tropical rainforest areas of Africa. MPX is part of a family of viruses known as the orthopox viruses. This is the same family of viruses that has things like smallpox and cowpox as well. Now, one of the interesting things about this family of viruses is that they can infect both humans and animals. Why is that significant? Because this virus can not only transmit from human to human, it can also transmit from animal to human and vice versa. Now, don't be fooled by the name monkeypox. It doesn't just target monkeys. In fact, it can also infect rats, guinea pigs, possibly even cats and dogs. So where has this virus come from and why are we hearing about it now? Well, in the last 5 years, there's been large outbreaks of MPX, starting in Nigeria. Since around 2018, people who were traveling to Nigeria have become infected and then returned to their home countries with the virus. Consequently, MPX has spread all over the world, and it hit Australia in about June 22. Does this mean it's the next pandemic? Not quite. The thing about MPX is that whilst it can technically be spread between animals and humans, it's most commonly transmitted through intimate human contact, mainly skin to skin. So the most likely way of contracting MPX is during sexual intercourse, where skin to skin contact is kind of inevitable. MPX can also be spread through body fluids like semen or through contact with contaminated clothing such as bedsheets. Now, whilst MPX can affect people of any gender or sexual identity, it is more common in men having sex with men and transgender people. Okay, so if you're worried about MPX, what do you need to look for? What are the symptoms? So the classic presentation is a rash that might look a bit like this. Firm, rubbery bumps or lumps that might be filled with fluid or pus. The rash may be confined to genital areas or the mouth, and these lesions themselves are often quite painful, at least at first. There's also a lot of other general symptoms that you can get: fever, muscle aches, and swollen glands. Like always, if you're worried, see a health professional for advice. Now, if you are exposed to MPX, there'll typically be a period of about 1 to 2 weeks before you develop symptoms, but this can be as long as 3 weeks in some cases. If left untreated, the virus will typically run its course and disappear within about 2 to 4 weeks. Most people will not develop severe complications, but there certainly have been cases where MPX has caused severe illness and even death, particularly when it affects people with a weakened immune system. So prevention is, obviously, ideal. And the first way to prevent MPX is just to avoid all human and animal contact. Of course, if that seems a bit extreme, there is a vaccination for MPX. And funnily enough, it's the same vaccine used for smallpox. Because the viruses are so closely related, the smallpox vaccines provide good coverage against MPX. The current vaccine being used is called Jynneos. This modified smallpox vaccine was developed in around 2019, and it's available in most developed countries now, including Australia. If you want to know more about this vaccine, including where you can access it, I'm posting some links in the description below. Now, speaking of crusty sores on the genitals, if you haven't seen my video on herpes, it's a ripper. So check it out. Stay healthy, guys, and see you soon.